It was incredible to pull up and to see the amount of girls standing outside and the excitement and these giant smiles. And I'm incredibly honored to be here today. I think when we kind of come together like this, this is where we start to empower girls, or encourage it at least for these girls to go out there and empower not only themselves, but their friends and their sisters. And so it's wonderful to be a part of that. I'm a girl. I am the mother of a little girl. I work in a country where more girls are infected with HIV and AIDS than anywhere else in the world. And we have realized in the past decade that a lack of education is the primary reason why they get infected. So there's a lot of reasons why this is very important to me. I have seen incredible strides, and I've seen incredible hope, because there's something that happens when you empower a young girl to feel confident and secure enough to talk about themselves, to talk about their bodies, to talk about their rights, to talk about what they deserve, what they should have, equal rights. Gender equality is a big issue in my country, and I think all over the world. So once you empower a young girl to understand that they have rights and that they can actually step forward and speak and have a voice, it's incredibly powerful to see how that has a trickling effect on their village, on the rest of their school, on their sisters and their brothers and their parents.
The energy here is incredible. I pulled up and there were just hundreds of girls in their school uniforms outside who all look so excited. They just can't wait to get in the doors, and I'm so excited to speak in front of them soon. We're launching the Girl Project with Glamour Magazine, and the panel that's going to happen today, all of these incredible women, including the First Lady of the United States, discussing what education means both here and globally. I think it's going to be a tremendously inspiring day. I wouldn't be here today, I wouldn't be speaking in front of all these incredible people, I wouldn't have the career that I do if it weren't for my education. And I've worked in the education space for a very long time, speaking in high schools and colleges in the US, and also traveling abroad and building schools in the developing world, and seeing the way that it changes the lives of the girls who are able to attend those schools, who are able to be in secondary school here. It's an undeniable and beautiful thing to witness. One of the reasons that what Glamour has put together here today is so important and so powerful is because they've been working in this space for a long time as well, and have realized that they have the bandwidth to be affecting change both in the US and abroad at the same time. And that's what the Girl Project is all about, elevating women everywhere.
We're here for a great panel talking about the importance of girls' education and the power that it generates when you allow a girl to get her education. And we're really excited because Glamour's The Girl Project is teaming up with Let Girls Learn, which is an initiative of the President and First Lady. So First Lady Michelle Obama will be with us, Charlize Theron, who's an incredible activist in her home country of South Africa, Julia Gillard, who is the former Prime Minister of Australia and an incredible advocate for education, and also a young woman named Nurfahada from the Philippines, who's going to talk about her own experience fighting to get the right to go to school in a culture that does not always encourage that. Among the panelists today is First Lady Michelle Obama, which is an incredible honor for Glamour, and we're really proud that Glamour's The Girl Project is collaborating with Let Girls Learn, which is the First Lady's initiative to support the idea of girls' education everywhere. We started The Girl Project last year in partnership with four national and international organizations to allow our readers to support the rights of girls to go to school everywhere. You can go to thegirlproject.com, you can go to letgirlslearn.com, and additionally, you can turn to a girl you know in your community and encourage her to stay in school.
I am truly impressed at the work that Glamour magazine is doing on girls' education. It's a tremendous initiative from the magazine, but what's even better to see is how engaged the readers are, how engaged the audience is. And it gives me a lot of heart that women of all ages, but particularly young women who are readers of Glamour magazine, are onto this issue and want to make a difference across their lifetimes. And of course, the First Lady and her personal leadership is so important to bringing this to the forefront of the attention of world leaders here in New York and beyond.
Education is something that is a real priority for the Apollo, and through our education programs we impact 18,000 school children through the different things that we do. So for us to be able to welcome Glamour and the First Lady and all of the other supporters here is like amazing. I'm so excited about it.
Take one more.
Everyone, please make some noise for the editor-in-chief of Glamour magazine, Cindi Leive.
This week, as the United Nations General Assembly has gone on around us here in New York City, something wonderful has happened, and that is that a lot of people have been talking about girls. Girls' health, girls' education, girls' rights, talking about girls. This is crucial, but we want to do something a little bit different here today. We don't just want to talk about girls, we want to talk to girls. That's why a year ago, in partnership with CARE, Plan International USA, Girls Inc., and Communities in Schools, Glamour and Condé Nast launched the Girl Project, an initiative that helps all of us support girls' education and supplies everything from safe transportation to tuition to school supplies. Give it up for our First Lady, Michelle Obama.
If I worry about who liked me and who thought I was cute when I was your age, I wouldn't be married to the President of the United States today. So.
That's amazing. That's so great.
For me, this is personal. You know, when I think about those 62 million girls that aren't in school, I think about myself, I think about my daughters, because quite frankly, all these girls, these are our girls. And I think about where I would be in my life if I didn't work hard in school and have the opportunity to go to college and then on to law school. I wouldn't be here. So I think it's imperative. And it is part of my passion and my mission to make sure that every girl on the planet has the same opportunity that I've had, that my daughters have. And I want to make sure that all of you here in the United States are taking advantage of the opportunities that you have as well. I want you to be that hungry to get your education because it is going to be the key to your future. So we're really working to engage everyone on the ground, all around the world, but we also want you all to be aware of this. So a huge part of Let Girls Learn is public awareness here in the U.S. We want you guys to know about these 62 million girls, and we want this to spur and inspire you to not take your education for granted. Because let me tell you, there are 62 million girls around the world who would give anything to be in your position.
I think a lot of girls, even in this country, sometimes still think that doing well in school will not make them more attractive to boys, or that it'll actually make them less attractive. I would like you smart, attractive, wonderful women to respond to that. Is there any truth to that?
There is nothing sexier than a smart woman. We have been told to live by a certain mold, women, especially women, and it's time to break it. And it is up to us to do that. Stop waiting for men to do that. Look in the mirror and see yourself and say, I am sexy, I am attractive, I am smart, I am intelligent, I am powerful, I have a voice, I look cute in these jeans. Yes, I don't have long hair, I have short hair, but I am still a girl, and I'm still hot. That's up to us. We have to take ownership in all of that stuff. We can't have boys designate that for us anymore.
And let's just be clear. You don't want to be with a boy that's too stupid to know what and appreciate a smart young lady.
For myself personally, coming from South Africa, where we have the highest population of HIV, people living with HIV, we have done so much research on the field of education, and we know that stopping AIDS lies within education. And so this is so interconnected, you can't do one without the other. AIDS is the number one killer in Africa of adolescents. It's the number two killer of adolescents globally. So we are very affected by our health, and we now know that there's research that education is connected to making good health choices, and so we save lives. Education is actually saving lives. And I'm so glad to know this is something that's really stuck with me, but the Global Health Campaign has said that education is a social vaccine against HIV. The empowerment of women is so important. I believe that poverty, world hunger, health issues, all of this stuff lies within the empowerment of young girls and women.
She's traveled here. She's here in the United States. She's sitting on the panel with the First Lady of the United States, and she's holding her own. Now, just imagine what, just imagine if she couldn't get an education. What a waste. What a waste that would be.
Nurfahada, what's the one thing that people should do?
Let's just support like this kind of program or like this kind of event, like this kind of project that will help girls to go to school without being afraid, without being ashamed, without being the shyness, being trauma because of what happened to her. And also, I believe that we are a girl advocate in our own ways. That's how we live our life.
For you in your future, that means that nations that you think of now as places of poverty and places of disorder could be on a path to peace and prosperity because we are educating the children, and particularly because we're educating the girls. So individually, your life's journey matters to you, but actually the life's journey of these 62 million girls matters to the world that you're going to live in.
If one thing I know,
one thing,
I'm far, but I'll grow.
I'll grow.
I'm walking now, this road.
Here we go.
This road.
One, two, three,
so well, I'll grow. That's just how I feel. That's just how I feel. That's just how I feel. Trying to reach the things that I can't see.
I can't see.